Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Happy weekend. Amen. How are you? How are you? How's your family? God bless you and God's face to shine upon you in Jesus' name. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, wherever you're watching from. This is Every Word of God for Daily Living, where we come to eat the Word of God and be filled with the Word of God and the knowledge of His will every day. As you have come today, the Lord bless you richly in Jesus' name. Amen. Let's pray. Our precious Father, King of glory, Lord of Lord, I bless you. I give you glory, honor, adoration. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for your mercies. Thank you, Father, for your grace. Great is your faithfulness towards us. Lord, I bless you and I give you glory, honor, adoration. You are wonderful. You're worthy to be praised. Blessed be your holy name, Lord Jesus. I give you all the glory. Thank you, Father, for our lives. Thank you, Father, for bringing us here day by day, day and night. Oh, Lord, your faithfulness is forever. Be thou exalted. Be thou glorified in the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. Thank you, Lord. We give you glory and adoration. Receive all glory. Receive all praises, O Lord, in the name of Jesus. Lord, we are here to receive from you, O God. Father, we pray that you come and speak to us, O Lord. Teach us your will, the knowledge. Give us the knowledge of your will, O God, in the name of Jesus. Give us all wisdom through your word, O Lord, and cause us to understand spiritually in the name of Jesus. Open the eyes of our understanding, O Lord Jesus, that we will know the hope of our calling in the name of Jesus. Father, Lord, I pray thee, O God, that you will open the eyes of somebody today, oh God, to your truth, oh God. Father, give grace, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Speak through my mouth, oh Lord. I humble myself, oh God. Speak through me, oh God. Be glorified. Glorify yourself in our midst today, in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Glory to your name. I humble myself. Jesus, speak, oh God. Holy Ghost, speak, oh God. Speak to heal. Speak to deliver. Speak to set free, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Be thou exalted. Thank you, oh God. Hey, Kalabashataya. Bless be your holy name. Thank you, God. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Join me and sing this song together. Blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. Blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. Oh, what a far state of glory divine. Heir of salvation, purchased of God, born of His Spirit, washed in His blood. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior. In my Savior, all that they long. Perfect submission, perfect delight. Visions of rapture burst now on my side. Angels descending, bring from above. Echoes of mercies, whispers of love. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all that day long. Perfect submission, all is at rest. I in my Savior, I'm happy and blessed. Watching and waiting, looking above. Filled with His goodness, lost in His love. This is my story, this is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior.
seen my Savior. Oh, that they long. Hallelujah. We praise our Savior, Jesus Christ, the Lord, the Redeemer, the God, the King of glory, and the Lord of Lord. We praise Him all day long. May the Spirit of praise take us over, that every moment, every hour, every second, our heart will bless the Lord. Our heart will praise the Lord. In Jesus' name, amen. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. We thank God for another day. In the name of Jesus, amen. Our topic today is Methods of Family Planning. This is by Pastor Parika, the International Director of the Holiness River Movement Worldwide, short from Horemo. Today is Saturday, January 15, 2022, and our text is for the book of Proverbs, chapter 25, verse 16 and 27. Verse 16, "Hast thou found honey? Eat so much as is sufficient for thee, lest thou be filled therewith and vomit it." Verse 27, "It is not good to eat much honey, so for men to search their own glory is not glory." Key verses taken from the book of Proverbs, chapter 22, verse 3. "A prudent man foreseeth the evil and hideth himself, but a simple pass on and are punished." God help us to be prudent in Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. I take our reading. Family planning is essential to control childbearing. The couple, therefore, must seek medical advice. The method must not be the one that kills an already formed child. We must be very, very careful. Whatever method you use, it should not be the one that makes you a murderer. For the Bible said we should not kill. When the child, there's a different kind of family planning you can use. There are others that when the child is already formed, it kills the child. We should be very, very careful. Before you go for family planning, ask questions. You see, if I take this one, the child has already formed, or is before the child formed, or it prevents the eggs from coming together. Be very, very careful as a child of God that is working His holiness and His righteousness. Be careful for family planning, and the Lord will help us in Jesus' name. Amen. The method you must use is the one that makes that, the method that you use, let it not be the one that makes you a murderer. Medical advice becomes important here because without counsel, purposes are disappointed, but the multitudes of counselors, but in multitude of counselors, they are established. This is Proverbs chapter 15, verse 22. Without counselors, purposes are disappointed. If you are not counseled proper, when you go to make family planning, God will even be against you because you are a sinner, you are a murderer. But in the multitude of counselors, you seek advice. Oh, from your sister, which one you're using? But which one are you using? Oh, okay, this is the right one. Oh, when I go to the doctor's office, I'll ask them about this. I'll ask the doctor which one is good for me. But a multitude of counselors, they are established. Amen? Amen. Some people say they use withdrawal methods so that the semen is not spilled inside the woman, but outside. And in that way, they are able to control situations, so they don't need any family planning from the doctors. What caused the slaying in the book of Genesis chapter 38, chapter 38, verses 8 to 9, is wickedness, for refusing to do good to a fellow man and for hardening their hearts. It is not that when your semen fell on the floor or fell out, you have sinned. If the method of withdrawal serves you, it is okay. Go ahead. It is not wickedness against your wife, or wickedness against anyone, or wickedness against any person, or it's even against God. It is because you want to keep to scriptural wisdom and advice, and that advises you in order to control the number of child you have. It is not a sin. This is emphasized here. Maybe you are just coming to this platform and like, what is this sister saying? Oh, we already know about this. Many people, they don't want to use family planning. In fact, even I was like one of them. I said I want to use faith. But how strong is your faith to hold on? Some people say withdrawal is a sin. Oh, why would they look at what happened in the book of Genesis chapter 38? That one is a different case. This one does not purposefully, it's just like a man that the wife is crying for a child and he's purposefully not pouring inside the wife. is purposefully not allowing his wife to bear child. That is a sin. Because those men, they sinned against God. That's why God killed them. This one is different. That you have children now. You are satisfied with children. And you say, no, my wife, I don't want to have more children. And then you decide that you pour out instead of pouring in. That is no longer a sin. It's what you have proposed. It's an agreement between you and your wife. Amen? Amen. You can go ahead to do it. It is not a sin. Proverbs chapter 25, verse 16 says, "Hast thou found honey? Eat so much as it is sufficient for thee, lest thou be filled therewith and vomit it." Eat as it is sufficient for you. You have a lot of children. You have 10 children. You have 7. You have 5 children. How? With the economy of today. Oh, yes, you have the money. You can give birth to as many children as you want, and you have girls to help you. What about their spiritual state? Do you know that you are accountable to every child? Do you know you are accountable to every child in the presence of God? God has given you that child for you to train that child up. You are responsible to that child. So if that child is failing, what are you going to tell God? That God gave you a child, but you cannot take care of the child. You allow that child to become a wayward child. You allow that child to become a worldly child. Because every child needs attention to train them, to bring them up, to nurture them in the way of God, so that tomorrow they will become great people. Do you have that time? You are working for money to train the child. Your husband too is working for money to train the child. And then you give the children to house helps. Say you have money, right? And now you can give birth to all the children. What are you doing to yourself? You are condemning those children. You are making those children to go to the world while you are spending your time working. And God will ask you, God will hold you accountable for those souls that you didn't train well. So that is why wisdom is profitable to the rect. The Lord give us wisdom that we can use these things to help ourselves, to prevent how many child. Go ahead. If the Lord say, okay, you want to have faith, fine. I hope your faith is strong enough. You want to withdraw, you know you can be able. Praise God. Go ahead. You want family planning? Search for the one that is good, that does not make you a murderer. Go ahead to the glory of God. Amen. Some use this condom. It is not if it satisfies you. In all, any method which is suitable to both man and woman, and it is not an offense against God, particularly not killing an already formed child. That is advised. You can go ahead to use that. That is clean. That is righteous. That is acceptable. You may say, this method will affect me. It is a risk. It's not beneficial to me. It will do this or it will do that. Tell me the thing in life that is not a risk. My dear, everything is a risk. What is that thing that is not a risk? What is that thing in life that you do that lasts risks? Even drinking water, it's a risk. If you do not drink that water with care, it might go through your throat. It might go wrongly to a place, and then you start choking. You start coughing. Risk is part of life, but we manage risk to move forward in life. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We manage risk to move forward in life. Amen. Therefore, use that method which is suitable to the woman. But wisdom must come into it also. Use wisdom. Ask. Seek counsel. Amen. And God will help us in the name of Jesus. Amen. It is not wise for you to say, let us go to remove the womb. Are you going to, do you know the day you will die? Are you going to live forever? It is not wise to say, let's go and remove the womb. It is not a wise decision. It is not a wise thought for you to think, oh, woman, go and remove the womb. I've already have even 4 children. Let's go and remove the womb. I don't need it again. It is not a wise decision to take. The woman is still young. And in the events of life, the husband may die. And she may need to remarry another man. So why are you removing that womb? God forbid, evil can happen. We have heard a lot of things that, these children and the father or the mother, they went and then they all died. And then this woman will have to remarry again. What about the womb? Instead of you, the womb to not be a blessing of you remarrying and getting other children, it will not be a something of course and something that you it will be of a regret. No, that is not an issue. There's a lot of ways that you can prevent giving birth instead of removing the womb. Amen. Why are you removing the womb? Who has told the two of you that you will live together till old age as God commanded you? That is God's creation, you know, because we have to be very, very careful in everything we do. You are removing a part that God has put there in you. Why are you removing it? Take it to God in prayer. He will guide you. The Lord wants your peace. Exercise wisdom. Amen. Some people say, oh no, this sister say she have bad effects. Oh, she have headaches. She have this, she have that. Pray concerning everything. You are not of the world. So therefore, pray. You're going to do this. It's what is the best for you. Pray about it. Put it in the hands of God. God, this is what I feel is the best for me. Bless it. Let the effects that happen to others, let it not happen to me. I think I was testifying here one time. As I was growing up as a child, I heard, oh, when you are pregnant, then you have to be having spit in your mouth. You have to be throwing. In fact, sometimes you can't even eat food when you are pregnant. That is the normal. It's a normal thing. Until I heard a man of God say that, not even a man of God, until I heard a testimony from a man in a church. And he said that when his wife was about to get pregnant, he told him, said that his wife will not have, it's even a man that stood in faith for his wife, it's not even the woman. He said that he was telling God that he does not want his wife to be spitting or vomiting or be choosing food. And God did it. When my ears heard that, that stirred up great faith in my heart. And I say, me, I shall not have spit. I shall not vomit. I shall eat all food when I'm pregnant. And that is how it is. When I'm pregnant, I am walking. I'm doing what I want to do. I am healthy. That is the blessings of God. As you prophesy, as you speak with your mouth, you have faith that as I do this, it shall work for me. And so shall it be for you. In Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. This is an interesting daily devotional today. It's only for the married. Hallelujah. Amen. Our thought for today is always seek for godly counsel and don't perish in your ignorance. A lot of people have perished. Oh, I have faith in God. And your faith is not even holding water, cannot even hold water. You are so fearful and you say you have faith because of fear. Oh, you don't know if God is God, we love it all, or maybe I'll go to hell. Instead of you say you are afraid, you say you have faith. Before you know, you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Your husband is already complaining. You are putting your marriage in jeopardy. You keep having children because you are afraid. That's not faith, that's fear. May the Lord help us in the name of Jesus. Our thought again, always seek for godly counsel and don't perish in your ignorance. Let's begin to pray. We intercede for those who are in ignorance. I remember before I think I was only having one, and a family of mine was like, sister, what do you say concerning this? I was still holding on my faith, and he said, I will not listen to you now until you are there. Indeed, now I know better. I am there, I'm experienced, and I can advise. Amen. Until you are there, before you can give advice to some certain things. And we are here and we say, don't let ignorance make you perish. Don't let what other people, it is working for that sister have faith that is working for her. This thing I just said about vomiting or spitting, it doesn't work for a lot of people. But as you have strong faith in God, it can work for you. But that your faith is not strong, it does not mean that you'll be killing yourself. God has also made another way, another alternative for you, a godly alternative that you can use. Use it for your peace in the name of Jesus. Let's pray and intercede that people, that God will give grace to those who are still struggling in faith. Oh, they disbelieve this. They are disbelieving and it's already a damnation to them. They are disbelieving and they already have problems in their marriage, that God will help them and have mercy on them. Let's begin to pray in the name of Jesus. Oh Lord, we pray thee, oh God, for your mercy, oh God, upon these ones. Now by your mercy, oh God, that you will give them grace, oh God, to see clearly, oh God, to take good counsel in the name of Jesus, that they will know what to do, that they may not damn their marriages or damn their soul in the name of Jesus. Father, I pray thee, oh God, those who are afraid, oh God, for family planning, I pray thee that by your mercy, oh Lord, that you will give them boldness and give them peace. Those who the family planning is affecting them, I pray thee, Father, that that you will heal them. Oh Lord, you will show them mercy in the name of Jesus. Amen. Thank you, Father, for the grace to bear children. Oh Lord, those that doesn't have children, we are talking about family planning. There are others that don't even have one. Jesus, I pray, have mercy, have mercy, have mercy, have mercy, have mercy. Oh, sisters, begin to intercede. Brothers, intercede. Have mercy. Give them children. Give them children. Bless them with their own. Bless them with their own. Give them their own, oh Lord. In the name of Jesus. Oh God, that sister, bless her. That brother, bless him. Oh Lord, with their own child. With their own child. In their marriages. In the name of Jesus. Bless them, oh God. Heal their womb, oh God. Heal their fallopian tube. Heal them, oh God. Father, cause their womb to bear children. To carry children. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Shataya. That this knowledge that they have learned today, they will use it in the next 4 years to come. They will use it in the next 5 years to come. They will use it, oh God, that is a knowledge that they will use to come, Father. Daddy, we pray that you will bless these ones with children. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you, Father. I bless you, Lord. We give you glory. For there's always a lesson to learn, oh God. You are always teaching us, Lord. Lord, we say thank you, Father. In Jesus' name. I bless our day in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. No weapon formed against us shall prosper. Every tongue that is risen up against us is consumed and condemned. In the name of Jesus, we receive wisdom to counsel people today. In the name of Jesus, that anyone that comes our way, we receive the wisdom from above to counsel them in the righteousness and the holiness of God. In the name of Jesus, make us great counselors of our time, that we will not lead people to hell. We will not lead people astray, but we will lead people to your kingdom, closer to you. In the name of Jesus, those who have been bounded, oh God, by evil counsels, oh Lord, I pray that you will bring them back to yourself, oh God. Have mercy, heal them, restore them back to you, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. It is well with our soul. We are blessed as we go forth. As we come in, it is well with us, in the name of Jesus. Blessed be your name. We give you glory. Hallowed to your name, Father. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We thank God for today. Have a wonderful Saturday. In Jesus' name, amen.